Για μένα είναι θεία.
Εντάξει, Νίκο.
Μη στενοχωριέσαι. Πήγαινε μέσα. Πήγαινε μέσα. Όχι, φορεστώ.
Εντάξει, Νίκο. Τι έχει ο Λούκας?
Α, δεν έχω ιδέα.
Δεν μιλάει.
Α, νέος είναι. Ό,τι θέλει ας κάνει, άφησε τον.
Αυτό είναι το μωρό.
Βαρέθηκα. Πάω να πάρω τσιγάρο.
Νίκο! Νίκο!
Να,
είναι
εδώ.
Oh, I don't understand.
A beer, sweetheart.
Oh, right.
Μπράβο.
Excuse me. Look, why does it take nearly an hour to get served here?
I'm very sorry. I'll try to hurry it up. What was it? The avgolemono?
Okay. Fellow dolmas humus tamasalata. Souvlaki ye yama. My husband was having the chicken.
Lucky.
Good evening, Sergeant.
Good evening, sir.
Been out?
A restaurant with a wife.
Really? Which one?
It wasn't too good, actually. Took ages coming. The Acropolis.
They were probably a bit short-staffed in the kitchen.
What do you mean?
Come and meet the chef.
Do we know what happened?
Stripped to pathologist's jargon, somebody called a few hours back and broke his neck. Someone who knew what they were doing, apparently.
When was he found?
An hour or so ago. The old couple downstairs thought he'd gone to work at the usual time. They heard the front door and assumed it was him going out. was more likely his killer.
Didn't the restaurant ring to ask why he hadn't turned up?
Yes, even before you started howling for your growl.
And that's when they looked in his room?
Yes. The going isn't easy. How's your Greek?
As a matter of fact, I've just started learning.
Chance for you to practice. Now, Mr. and Mrs. Pappas, this man upstairs, he is not your son. This man, your lodger. Your son is at the restaurant.
Acropolis, ne?
Yes, Acropolis, yes. His name is Dino.
Dinos, Konstantinos.
He reported the murder. Now, Nikos, he had a visitor tonight. Someone came to see him. Yes? Do you want to have a try?
No, not really. Well, I can say it's a nice day and ask them if they sell beer, that's about it.
I thought their son was on his way.
He was supposed to be, sir.
Come on. Not a lot more we can do here.
We are closed. It's after closing time.
Manager already told you, the place is closed.
I'm looking for Dino Pappas.
I'm Dino Pappas.
I thought you were coming home to interpret for your parents.
But I wanted to talk to him first.
And you are?
Vasilios Vasilakis.
Do I take it you own this place?
Among others. So I am naturally concerned when I happen to call in and find chaos and confusion, the kitchen staff about to mutiny. No, chef.
He was unavoidably detained. But knowing that, you keep this man here when I've already asked him to come and help us.
We have to open tomorrow. A new chef has to be found.
That's obstructing the police in the course of their inquiries, a criminal offense, a man's been killed.
He wasn't only my employee, he was my countryman.
How long had Nikos been your chef?
About 6 months. He, has his own family taverna in Piraeus.
So why did he leave it to work here?
Experience abroad. Learn to speak English.
Do you know if he had any enemies?
Nikos? No, not one.
Chefs aren't always popular with the staff, am I right?
Well, he was. Everyone loved him.
Someone didn't. Not one little bit. Right, shall we go and talk to your parents? That's the same T-shirt Nikos is wearing.
It's the staff uniform.
The design's from the Telos vase, yes?
I'm impressed.
The next time I call on someone to help with my inquiries, I don't want to have to come and get him.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
Sleep well?
Nope. You?
Like a log.
What about your chef?
PM report.
Which says what, roughly?
Fractured cervical vertebra, C1 or C2. The head was wrenched back, causing a compression of the spinal cord. A bit like whiplash, sir. Apart from that, we don't know much.
Oh, yes, we do. He was a good chef, well-liked. In fact, he was so popular that no one could possibly want to kill him.
Got nothing much from Dino.
Or Dino's parents, or Vasilakis. It's called closing ranks, Lewis. How about forensic?
No. No prints either.
Well, at least we have these prints. An ancient wooden ship. A baby. A family group which includes Nikos and an old couple, presumably his parents. A young woman who could be his wife, his sister, his girlfriend. And this, presumably, is the family business in Piraeus, which couldn't have been doing very well, or he wouldn't have left it.
Not in early spring, anyway, with the tourist season coming up.
But whenever I pressed him, Dino would say nothing more than that Nikos wanted to work in England.
To learn English.
CID, Lewis.
Yep. Right. Super wants to see you.
Well, if you've looked him up in this, you know all about him, then.
I knew anyway. But I wasn't about to feed his vanity by letting on. Vasilakis is one of those old Greek shipping families. Niarchos and Nassis. Not as rich, of course.
And far more respectable. He's a member of the Athenaeum. OBE, he's married into our nobility, he's a generous benefactor, the chairman of God knows how many charities. So if you knew all that, why did you go out of your way to get up his nose?
I didn't.
Oh, come off it, Morse, you pretended you didn't know his name.
Ethnic cases aren't up my street. Don't speak the language, don't receive the signals people of the same race make to each other, or else try to conceal. Watch the mouth, it gives away what the eyes try to hide.
Is that one of your quotes?
Quotations, yes. Lord Byron.
Well, he took a bit of a shine to the Greeks, didn't he? You find yourself another interpreter, Morse. And try not to antagonize the rich and the famous just for the sake of it.
What's her name? This is Miss Georgie. Hey, your Yardis. She teaches Greek in my wife's evening classes.
Hello.
Sergeant Lewis comes once in a blue moon.
Whenever I can get away. I thought you might be needing a translator, sir.
Is your Greek as good as your English?
Well, I've been over here a while now, but I'm bilingual. My parents moved from mainland Greece to New Zealand.
A New Zealand Greek? Funny old world it's turning into. When I was at school, it was all Maoris and Kiwis.
I bet it was pink as well.
Very. Well, shall we go? Give me those photographs, Lewis.
You stay here and find out more about the dead man.
Doesn't he ever say please or thank you?
Αυτός είναι ο Νίκος, η αδερφή του η Μαρία και το παιδάκι της. Η μητέρα και ο πατέρας τους.
Το μωρό του Νίκου.
Και της Μαρίας. Ο Νίκος δεν είναι παντρεμένος.
The girl is the dead man's sister, and the baby isn't his, but hers.
Has he got children of his own?
None. He's not married.
Do they remember seeing any other snaps in his room?
Μήπως είδε άλλες φωτογραφίες στο δωμάτιό του?
Όχι. Does the boat mean anything? Was he interested in ancient maritime history?
Το πλοίο έχει σημασία τίποτε?
You see, that's not a picture postcard. That's an actual snap. This is worse than drawing teeth.
Hello.
can't keep calling you Miss Yoriades as Lewis tries to.
Poor man. He nearly breaks his jaw on it. Jocasta will do.
Well, Jocasta, what do you make of our aged parents in there? Are they telling us the truth?
Not the whole truth, no. I get the feeling they've decided on a story and they're sticking to it.
Or Dino has.
Randall Rees over there. He's the man on Greek naval history.
Which one?
Beside the rather attractive boy with a punk hairdo.
But your thesis is...
No, I once had very high hopes of Randall. He was a brilliant classical scholar, single-handedly swept away all previous notions of how early naval battles had been conducted. Everyone was sure nothing could stop him cutting a swathe through academia. But we reckoned without Friday.
Without what?
Mrs. Rees.
Friday? What's that, American?
You'd think so, yes. In fact, it's short for Fried Swide, the first of the name being daughter to a king of Mercia who fled to Oxford to preserve her virginity from an importunate prince.
And became the city's patron saint, yes.
Ah, you did know.
Well, I've heard of Fried Swide, but not its diminutive.
Still used locally.
So how did she influence her husband?
She's on the master's left. Surely you know her face.
Have you been following?
I have, everybody.
I'm told it's one of the best known in the country. The face that launched 1,000 clips. That's a technical television term, Morse.
I hardly ever watch.
Oh, dear. Here's the master, gone to all this trouble to catch his tame celebrity, but to no avail. Half the nation looks to her to solve their marital and medical problems, and you don't even know.
So how did she spoil her husband's scholarship? Aren't they happy?
If you believe the popular press, theirs is a marriage made in heaven. Hold on to your napkin.
I know, I've been through this pantomime before.
Are you saying that Rees only married to hide his true nature?
Oh, would I imply anything so outrageous? Certainly tongues wagged. The usual college gossip, you know. But anything to do with naval battles, he's your man.
Yes, of course.
Randall? Terry, where have you been hiding this term?
Dining out a great deal.
But I was asking for you in the King's Head the other day. They said they haven't seen you for 3 weeks. And how are your parents keeping?
Tell us fast. Where did you come across that?
On a T-shirt. Well, on half a dozen T-shirts, actually. Now, the point is, I knew what it was, but it's years since I read anything along those lines. What's its significance?
Ah, well, you've come to the right man.
So I'm told.
I've actually done quite a bit of work on it recently. I don't know if you heard of our symposium in Greece last year.
No, I'm sorry, I didn't.
Oh. It was quite an event. Very exciting for those of us working in that field. A symposium on ancient Greek seamanship. Lectures, film shows, a lot of talk, you know, kind of thing. But for me, the most thrilling things of all were the reconstructions.
What do you mean, scale models?
Oh, no. Real thing. Life size. Fully operational.
And when was this, you say?
Last summer. In Piraeus. It was the first attempt to bring together all the reconstructed ships of antiquity in one place. We had the Pentaconto. The Argo. Quadriremes and quinqueremes. And, of course, the trireme, which is my particular love child.
So where does the vase come in?
Okay. Behind the three figures on that vase is part of the stern of a ship, the trireme. It was one of several clues that led the first scholars to the final design. A bit like your line of work, I suppose. All trace of the vessel had been lost. We had to piece it together from this and that. Excuse me.
Saying they reconstructed the whole boat from a sketch on a vase?
No, there was also a phrase in Plato, a sketch on a relief, a reference in Aristophanes to farting in the face of the chap rowing beneath you.
Well, there would be, wouldn't it?
Not much to go on, but put all the clues together. All this was described in the film we made. That might have been what you saw. We had to popularise it a good deal, but the result wasn't really as shameful as it might have been.
He's not boring you with that old boat again, is he?
No, not at all.
Coffee?
Thank you.
You only have to mention triremes and he'll talk a gramophone to scrap. You better circulate, Randy, dear.
Your husband suggested that scholarship is not unlike my game.
The police?
The CID. You blunder along in the dark, looking for a glimmer to light the way.
Well, at the risk of disloyalty, it sounds a lot more lively than Greek old ships.
I'm sorry, I've never seen one of your programs. I hear they're very good.
They seem to help people.
I understand it's as much by being what you are as what you say.
Well, I try. Some of it's bound to be a bit of a performance, of course, but one part is absolutely genuine. Randall and I. You married, Inspector?
No.
I recommend it.
So I understand.
Well, I saw you were granted an audience with a TV star.
She's charming.
No question. Millions are charmed by every Saturday. Poor Terry seemed very bored by Randall's attentions, I thought.
Never give up, do you, Jerome? So, a very agreeable evening, as always. My turn next.
Good luck with your murder.
Vessel put together in a rare time. Two words, 1-7.
Well, if you already know the answer.
It's a kind of mental jogging, Lewis. Good for you.
A trireme.
Very good, Lewis. Anagram of rare time. How did you know?
I saw a film about it on the telly. Well, I was on duty. Valerie videoed it for me.
Part of your Greek culture course. You still got it?
I doubt it. Kids tape over everything.
Seems the dead man had no form.
It sounds almost philosophical, Lewis. Formless, was he?
Lived a very quiet kind of life, according to everybody we spoke to. Hardly ever went out of here except to work. He was saving all his money to keep the family firm going.
Which was failing.
Right. But it wasn't true that he wanted to learn English. He'd already worked a whole summer season here at a hotel in Devon.
Had he?
Owned by a bloke called Tuckerman. Bit of a dodgy customer by the sound of him.
What about the sister?
Oh, she worked for Tuckerman too. She's expected over from Greece for her brother's funeral.
Maria.
Dino. Τι μας βρήκε, Τίνο μου.
Ξέρω, μάνα μου. Τι να σε κάνω.
Από πού.
Αξιομακάριστε και αείμνηστε αδερφέ ημών Νικόλαε. Αιωνία σου η μνήμη, αξιομακάριστε και αείμνηστε αδερφέ Νικόλαε. Αιωνία σου η μνήμη, αξιομακάριστε και αείμνηστε αδερφέ ημών Νικόλαε.
I was surprised they decided to bury him in England.
I don't think they could afford to take him back to Greece.
She must have been very fond of her brother. She's weeping buckets.
We show our feelings more than you do.
Never seen a Greek tragedy, Lewis?
Oh, I saw Zorba. And never on a Sunday.
I'll have to come and question Maria later today.
Can't you leave it till tomorrow? If I could gain her confidence, she might tell me something. You would frighten her.
I don't like to think of her alone here in this state.
She's not alone. Just look at them all.
Just the same. If you could see, no harm comes to her.
Good morning, Chief Inspector.
Morning.
I owe you an apology. Over being bloody-minded when you wanted Dino's help.
Oh, that was nothing.
I do take a pride in my restaurants.
Even though Greek's not among the great cuisines of the world?
Like English, exactly. I prefer to eat French myself. But our best food is better than most foreigners think, and we should be proud of it. I have been trying to give my fellow Greeks a sense of national pride ever since I discovered how some foreigners regard us.
How is that, do you think?
As Dagos, Levantines, a third world country on the fringe of Europe.
That's not a view that an educated man would take.
An educated man. Can I offer you a lift, Chief Inspector? An educated man, in England, for example, always makes a clear distinction between the glory that was Greece and the mess it is today. There were the Athenians, now there are the savages who replaced them, who aren't even capable of looking after their own antiquities.
I thought it wouldn't be long before we got round to the Elgin Marbles. Last time I was at the Acropolis, a guide said to our party in a very loud voice,
Greece has two enemies, the Turks and Lord Elgin. I said, good God, that was nearly 200 years ago.
Yes, and they're still in the British Museum. Believe me, Chief Inspector, attitudes haven't changed. Let me give you an example. I have been involved in a scheme to reconstruct the most famous boats of ancient Greek history.
Oh, you mean the symposium at Piraeus last year?
Some of them were there, yes. I had forgotten your interest in the classics. The point is that those boats are part of our history, our heritage. But that is not good enough for some. There was this man at the event, Tuckerman.
Digby Tuckerman?
Yes. You know him.
Only his name.
Well, if you're a policeman, I am not surprised. An unsavory character with a reputation for some very questionable business methods. He's ruined a few people in his time. And Tuckerman now fronts a leisure group making historical theme parks. He's trying to bring one of the reconstructed boats to this country to decorate his tacky sideshow. He'll have actors running around in sailors' costumes with parrots on their shoulders shouting, "Sure, my timbers," I shouldn't be surprised. A vulgar travesty. He says money is no object. But my sources tell me that his financial basis is... he's a man of straw. He's nothing.
You don't like him?
No. No. I don't have the appetite for him. But more than that, I don't like the idea that the treasures of our past are only there to be plundered for personal gain and self-aggrandizement. The old imperialist ethic that inspired Lord Elgin hasn't disappeared, Chief Inspector. It's just assumed a new guise.
Thank you. you for seeing me. It is a pretty hairy moment for me, actually, so I hope it won't take too long.
I hope so, too.
Can I take your coat?
Thank you.
Would you like a drink? Tea, coffee, mineral water, scotch?
Scotch and water, please. So, what branch are you in?
The Mets. Thames Valley, CID.
Could have saved yourself a trip. I live near Oxford.
Yes, yes, I uncovered that information. So this is your London office?
I rent it by the day. They're used by accountants and solicitors from out of town to impress the punters. Costs an arm and a leg, but if you're trying to get a project off the ground, it's the right ambiance.
And that's what you're doing at the moment?
No secret. I hope not anyway, after all I've spent on hype. Yeah, I've formed a consortium to build the first of a chain of marine theme parks.
And bring over a Greek ship?
Right.
Think they'll let you?
No question. Well, one or two very touchy people think it'll be the end of civilization if I do. The send home the marbles lobby. Wouldn't you think they'd simply jump at the chance to show it abroad? I would think of the media blitz there'd be.
Perhaps they're afraid they'll never get it back.
The frog's got the Mona Lisa back after it had been to New York.
The Italians didn't.
But I mean, our scholars did the spade work. It was designed here.
But paid for by the Greeks.
I guess you didn't come all the way from Oxford to discuss Greek oared ships.
I'm investigating the murder of Nikos Kapparis.
Saw it in the local rag. Poor guy.
As you say, poor guy.
Thanks.
Were you in or around Oxford at about 6 on Monday evening?
Better bring in my organizer, Laura. Thanks.
He was your sous chef at the Golden Fleece?
About 2 years ago, yeah.
Why did he leave?
Well, the Golden Fleece got into deep trouble. Don't ask me why. Too upmarket for South Devon, perhaps. Anyway, I had to close it. Nico and his sister went back to the family business in Piraeus, no worse off. The receiver took over what was left.
Not for the first time.
No, afraid not. If you're a high flyer among oiks,
the cash and carry, the yacht fitting business, the disco, the Spanish restaurant. In fact, a trail of abortive enterprises all along the south coast. And every time some oiks had to pick up the pieces, well, you swanned off to a new place and a new disaster.
Now listen, there's nothing sticking to me from all that. I'm clean. Right. Monday, early evening, was it?
6 o'clock-ish.
I was in a meeting with a Mr. Saeed Akbar.
Oh, that was for 4:30. Plenty of time to drive to Oxford after that.
He didn't leave until close on 6. Ask my secretary. Ask my wife, she'll tell you. I didn't get home till after 8.
And you haven't seen Nikos since your hotel went bust?
Well, I knew he was back working over here.
For your friend Vasilakis. And you didn't bump into him or his sister at that maritime symposium?
They were in Piraeus. I was mostly in Athens, moving in very different circles. So, this is the time of the high flyers, Inspector. Only the brain dead stay on the ground.
Ever heard of Icarus?
No, why? Did he work for me?
I meant on your wanderings through antiquity. A mythical figure, the first birdman, flew too near the sun, melted the wax on his wings, fell from the sky and was drowned in the Aegean.
Well, that's all very interesting, Inspector.
I may come and see you at home.
Feel free. Of course, I'm only there evenings and weekends. Not always then.
Thanks for the drink.
Thank you.
Just ring in your place, see if he got back. Any joy?
Nothing positive. The train was delayed. I don't think Tuckerman's telling all he knows. I think it's time we spoke to the sister.
Yeah. Well, that's the snag, you see.
What?
Well, I'm afraid we've lost her.
I was taken by surprise. She gave me the slip while we were shopping.
You've checked the obvious places.
Dino's restaurant we've checked. Where else?
Why did she bring the baby anyway? There must have been a woman about in a Greek house.
They just keep on saying they don't know.
Is she still feeding it?
Him.
Huh?
Not it, him. No, they can be weaned easily by 6 months.
So why did she bring...
Κάτι κρύβεται, κύριε Πέτρο. Πρέπει να μας πείτε την αλήθεια.
Δεν ξέρουμε τίποτα. Μιλάτε με τον Τίνο. Μόνο αυτός ξέρει.
She knows something. But he says we mustn't ask them anymore. Only their son knows. Dino, we must speak to him.
Dino, talk to him, yes?
Does Dino know she's gone missing?
Dinos, ξέρει ότι χάθηκε η Μαρία.
Δεν θέλω να στενοχωρηθεί το παιδί. Πριν λίγες έφυγε αυτή. Σε λίγο θα επιστρέψει.
They didn't want to frighten him too soon. I mean, after all, she's only been gone a few hours. She could be back at any moment.
Let's go. I'd sooner listen to Dino's Ken Bazooki than this.
Yes, yes.
I don't know how parents can bear that noise.
They can't. That's what it's for. It forces you to do something.
Do you want a table?
What I want, Mr. Pappas, is a serious talk. Where can we go?
I cannot leave right now. As you can see, we are very busy.
Yes, and so am I. Get someone to cover.
Look, I have told you all I know.
Maria Kaparis has gone missing. She ran away. Who has she gone to see and why? Who is it you're hiding?
Vilaselinika? Δεν μου σε έχουν εμπιστοσύνη, καταλάβεις μου.
Κοίταξε, εσκοτώθηκε ο φίλος σου. Και τώρα χάθηκε η αδερφή του, η Μαρία. Θες να πάθει και αυτή κακό.
Better come through here. Maria has no husband. So, when she becomes pregnant, well, you can imagine. She comes from an old-fashioned Greek family, and naturally they want to know who the father is. Well, she says it's somebody that lives in England, who is only in Greece for the business with the boats.
The baby's age, of course.
Is it someone who lives in Oxford or outside?
I don't know. Nikos knew. He spent most of the time he was working here out looking for him.
And what did they hope to get from him?
Maria wanted to see him. To show him the baby. She had some idea that the man would want to marry her. Anyway. Nikos found out that, of course, the man's already married. So then he thinks perhaps the man would pay to keep the secret from his wife.
But what was he like?
Rich or poor?
Old or young? Middle-aged? Not even Greek or English.
Πόσες φορές να τους πω, δεν ξέρω τίποτε, α!
Εντάξει, Ρεντινό. Look, he's already told us he knows nothing.
You told us you knew nothing before. This is a murder inquiry. That's a criminal offence. Is that clear? Did either of them mention Digby Tuckerman?
Yes. They worked for him when they first came to England. But the restaurant went bust. They couldn't get another job and they couldn't stay in England without one. So they had to go back home.
And they never saw him again since then?
Yes, Nichols used to see him, I think.
You think? You don't know?
What did he see him about? Did he know anything about Tuckerman's business affairs in Devon? Enough to be a danger to him?
I can't make guesses. I can only tell you what I know.
You should have told us all this as soon as Nikos was killed.
It was a private matter.
Murder usually is. Thank you for helping.
Thank you for letting me. Of course, I've got a bit to learn about tailing people.
Don't blame yourself for that. If anyone's to blame, it's me. She'll turn up sometime.
I hope so. Good night.
Good night, and thank you. A very appealing girl.
I'm not the sort that fancies, teacher.
I didn't say I fancied her.
No. So, where to now?
Home. Come and have a drink.
Well, if it's all the same to you, sir.
All right. I'll just drop you off then.
I found that tape.
What tape?
For 2,500 years, boats from ancient Greece sailed through the Aegean, owned and paid for by the Hellenic Navy, but powered by British oarsmen. A magnificent sight.
Marvellous sight, sir.
But also a triumph.
But what's it got to do with our murder?
Detection from a
I have no idea.
And after the hot and back-breaking hours aboard, a much-needed chance to relax at a local taverna.
Hold it. Wasn't that our victim? Can we look at that again?
So it is.
So that must be his restaurant.
And look who's here.
And our missing person.
It's been a wonderful 2 weeks for everyone. The oarsmen, or should I say, oarspersons, as a good number of them are women. The recorders, the Greek naval officers, and most of all, for us, the trireme scholars, who have finally been proved right. And it's good to know that the first reconstruction will be staying here, where it belongs. Because this has been a collaboration between Brits and Greeks. That's really what's made the whole thing worthwhile. The way the local people treated us. We've been made to feel as though Greece is our second home.
What do you make of him, then?
Seems all right. Why?
Greek and ships, yes, but music by Elgar. I think I'll go and see Jerome Hogg again. Let me know the moment there's word of the girl.
What mother's gonna leave a baby, go off for a whole night in a town she doesn't know?
So what am I being accused of?
the love that dare not speak its name?
We have to find out what went on at the symposium.
Oh, they're there, dare to. Passing through Piraeus on one of those cultural cruises I do most summers. You know, Hellenic tours. I lecture on the glory that was Greece.
But you knew Nikos, did you?
In the biblical sense, no. I sometimes ate and drank at his taverna. More than that.
You're usually a very keen observer of who's doing what with whom.
Not when it's been taken down and used in evidence against them. I'm not a spy. Strange having a policeman for a friend. You've suddenly got your other hat on, your helmet. It's not you at all.
I don't care what went on amongst the British crew, but between the Brits and the Greeks.
Good deal of bad feeling, I gather. You know, the Greeks felt it was their boat, but the British insisted on treating it as theirs.
Jerome, you know what I mean.
Hanky panky.
Hello, sailor. There's a lot less of that than in the good old days. I suppose I'm lucky. So in my wild days before the scourge came. Now I'm an old man. The hunger's abated somewhat.
But how about the young men?
About 200 of them. Even my taste for gossip would find that prospect daunting.
I was thinking of Digby Tuckerman, Randall Rees, even Basilios Vasilakis. They were all there.
You must speak to them.
Well, thank you.
What for?
The coffee.
Now, I was worried for a moment. In case I'd given you something else.
Stolen baby, it'll be on the national news. As you see, we need results.
I'm as concerned about this as you are, sir.
Well, let's look at the facts, shall we?
Well, forensic found almost nothing on the dead man, sir.
Did you do a blood test on the baby?
Well, that can't tell you who the father is, only who it's certainly not.
Well, can we rule out ethnic squabble of some kind?
Unless it's Mr. Vasilakis.
We've got him on film, sir. Talking to Maria at her taverna.
Tuckerman is desperate. His fellow conspirators have to be persuaded to put money into his theme park. The last thing he wants is someone showing his dirty linen. So if Nikos had threatened to tell all he knew...
In which case, why has the kid been stolen?
Who steals babies? Demented, pitiful women. Some poor creature read about Maria's disappearance and thought, there's a motherless child, I'll look after it.
You don't suppose it could be the mother herself, do you?
Maria?
With the father at last? Playing happy families while the rest of us are thinking the worst?
Well, who else?
Professor Randall Rees. He's married to Friday, the famous television wife.
Dream husband's secret love nest. That'll be a national scandal, wouldn't it? My wife, for one, would have to go into intensive care. No, hang about, that won't wash. Don't you remember a few years ago they faced a shock nation with the news that we're both a bit under par in the baby-making department?
Oh, that's right, sir. I knew there was something niggling me. My wife saw that programme. I remember her saying it must have been a terrific help to other people in the same situation.
In what way, exactly? Sounds nauseating. What is this modern compulsion to entertain unknown millions with your closest secrets?
You come from a pre-telly generation.
I don't know, sir. I think people like the Reeses can help other childless couples come to terms with the problem.
All right. He was next on my visiting list, anyway.
And so shall all my other books. But the answer to your question is yes, traces of hashish were found in the remains of the Punic ship, so the crews might well have been stoned at their oars, yeah.
Would it be a good idea at any future trials to lay on grass for all? That way they might get the speed up to 12 knots, as you say the Athenians did.
I'm not sure it would improve their performance. Daisy?
Of course, at the end of the day, what were you working to recreate? It's a beautiful battering ram. It's a cruise missile. Its sole purpose is to sink the enemy's fleet, break bones, and drown people. I mean, do you think in 2,000 years from now, some scholars will reconstruct our ICBMs and Polarises?
Okay. We all know how you feel about war, Daisy. But if history teaches anything, it's that life's not that simple. It was because of these ships that the Persian fleet was sunk and the barbarians kept at bay. Greek civilization was preserved as a model for the future of Europe and the world. Without the triremes, we may not have inherited the democratic ideals we still look to as our only hope against, well, against tyranny. I hoped I'd made that clear. Thank you.
I'm sure we'd all like to thank Professor Rees for his stimulating talk. I knew next to nothing about Greek oared ships before I came here today, but now I feel equipped to become one of the great bores of the day on the subject. Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry, I wanted very much to hear your talk. I couldn't get away.
Pity. Have become a great bore on the subject.
It wasn't the best vote of thanks in the Union's history. She'll be kicking herself all night.
I doubt it. She probably meant it. I'm having to face a very disagreeable truth. In the world's eyes, I've suddenly become a bore. Till a few years ago, I was the apple of everyone's eye. Look at the turnout. They used to fill this place.
I'm told you are one of the most brilliant scholars of your generation. That fair?
Good God, who by?
That night we met at High Table, I was told by Jerome Hogg.
Hell hath no fury like a woman scorned. When I'm married, rather late in the day, I left Jerome's little coterie of sycophantic young fogies. You're not married, are you?
No.
Best thing I ever did. I bet Jerome told you I did it to prove something. He's never been able to face the fact that I fell in love with Friday at first sight. And I've loved her ever since.
She didn't go with you to Piraeus.
She was halfway through a series.
Did you know Nikos and Maria Kaparis there?
Am I being questioned?
I'm talking to everyone.
Yes, I knew them. Nikos fed us at bargain prices. Most of the students couldn't afford to go out that much, but when we did, it was usually to the Kaparis Taverna. There were some rumors that Nikos might have been spying on us.
Spying? What? He's one of those old boats about to be bought by NATO.
No, by that chap Tuckerman.
Do you mean Nikos and his family were spying for Tuckerman?
I just thought they were listening at tables, yeah. Reporting anything useful back. Nothing was ever proved, of course.
How about a drink?
Sorry, ordinary way I'd love to, but Friday's getting dinner. I'm late already. I better ring for a cab.
Haven't you got a car?
It's in for servicing.
Well, I'll give you a lift.
There's no need, really.
No trouble at all.
Rang the union. I was...
Morse gave me a lift home.
I thought it was a taxi.
A vintage Jaguar? Hardly.
Blame me if he's late.
No, no, he's not. How was his talk?
I only heard the end.
Are you sure you won't come in for a low-alcohol beer?
Good God, no. There'll be alcohol-free whiskey next. Thanks, but no. Well, good night.
Thanks for bringing him home.
No. Oh, I've got him. Hey, bring that torch across here.
Right down inside and struggled to survive.
Are there any injuries?
Same as her brother. Compression of the spinal cord.
Can they give us the time?
Well, given the fresh water conditions and the warm weather, they reckon she could have been killed within, well, a matter of hours of giving Miss Yorgiadis the slip.
She won't be too happy about this.
She won't. Do you think I could let her know, sir? Before she reads it in the paper or sees it on the news?
Break it to her gently. I'll be at the Tuckerman's place.
Mrs. Tuckerman. Morse, CID. I rang earlier.
He isn't back yet. As I told you, he stayed in town last night.
Perhaps you can help me.
What do you have? G&T? B&S? Or shall I open champagne?
It's a little early for me, thanks. Did your husband tell you who he met in his London office?
He never tells me anything much these days. There was a time when I took an interest in his business affairs, but now they've entered the realm of fantasy.
His business affairs?
All his affairs. Businessmen are the world's dreamers, you know. Fantasists, everyone.
You seem to live pretty well on it.
Of course, you know, he doesn't own a thing. It's either this company or that consortium.
You were married 12 years ago. That was before he ran the Golden Fleece.
Give him his due. He's cheeky. Golden Fleece.
So you must have known Nikos and Maria Kaparis.
Always troubling, too. Always stirring it up. Still, I can't help feeling sorry for the girl. What she must be going through. God, what kind of people would do a thing like that?
Not your husband's kind, anyway.
Digger? Steal a baby? Well, he's not remotely interested in kids. Soon as ours could walk, he packed them off to some awful boarding school so that now I scarcely ever see them.
Boys?
Two girls.
I was thinking more of what was done to Nikos.
Digger's violence is all on paper. Or floppy disks. He can't stand the sight of blood.
In fact, no blood was spilled. Has he ever gone in for karate or tai chi?
Not that kind of sport he fancies at all, no. More boardroom and bedroom. You went to that office he rents by the day. Then you saw that girl he rents by the hour. Leggy Laura. He likes to go a few rounds with her.
You went with him to Piraeus, of course.
Oh, Athens mostly. Wining and dining.
He met the Kaparises there again.
I told you. He never tells me anything these days. Well, I try not to see what's going on. I just sit here, day after day. Waiting for him to come home.
I think you better not have another drink. You could be your husband's only alibi.
Well, why don't you ask him?
Hello again.
Nice old motor out there. Haven't you given Inspector Morse a drink? He likes a scotch on duty.
Not this early.
It's about Nico's murder again.
And Maria's.
You found her?
This morning, floating in the charwell.
Oh, no.
Drowned?
Killed first, driven there, then thrown into the river.
Poor kid, she was only a poor...
And the time of death is anywhere between 5 and 10 on Thursday.
Isn't that the day we met in London?
You could have driven here in an hour, been here when she arrived.
Hang on. You laying this on me?
Not until the post-mortem gives us a precise time of death, but I would like to take your car to forensic. Do you have a car, Mrs. Tuckerman?
Oh, for God's sake, Digger, tell him the truth!
Now, come on, love.
He didn't come home at all that night, so I can't say where he was. You'll have to ask Legs Laura.
You spent the evening with your secretary?
The evening that lasted until 12 the next day?
We were working on the new presentation in the office.
Till when?
Midnight. Till we got back to her place. Because it looks like I've lost that bloody boat and I've got to save what I can by next week.
Then where were you driving off to like a bat out of hell just after I left?
Up to Charlie, yeah, to try and save the whole bloody operation. He's the guy who's supposed to swing it all my way, but someone else got ahead of the game. That's the truth. It was a last ditch effort to save it. All the money I've spent greasing the right palms, doing the needful. Grease. Good name for that place.
So how do we talk to Charlie? And will Charlie talk for you?
He'd better.
And wasn't Nikos still on your payroll? Wasn't he your man in Piraeus, listening at tables, reporting back?
He was an informant, yes. That's not illegal.
And did he carry on doing it when he went to work in Vasilakis' restaurant?
Well, I needed someone to stand behind him and tip me the wink.
And did he find out more than you wanted? And did he turn to blackmailing you? And did Maria come and follow it up to avenge her brother?
I'm saying nothing more till I've spoken to my solicitor.
I'm sure he'll advise cooperation. Be sure to tell him you're not under arrest.
Who set me up? Was it that smarmy bubble?
I'll see myself out.
Vasilakis. Go and get me a beer. I don't want to talk to the mother's help, whatever it is you call yourself. I want Vasilakis.
You can't just push
away
here.
Don't be a silly girl. Vasilakis! I want you and I'm going to have you!
All right, Wendy. Come and take the baby.
You the wife? You tell him Digby Tuckerman's here to see him.
Yes, I know who you are. I see you arguing with Basilios on television.
He won't win, you know. Not that way. That's a rough old game, but two can play, believe me.
Mr. Tuckerman, would you please leave this house?
What? You call the police? Chums of yours, are they? I know your old man's here. Vasilakis! Come out, wherever you're hiding! Vasilakis!
You said to Tuckerman, sir. We've just had a call. He's broken into Vasilakis's.
Right, come on.
Follow us. Okay.
Get his head off. What's the matter?
Surprised? Thought you'd got me safely put away till after next week.
Who let you into my house?
Your mates in the police force, was it? Masonic handshakes, all that stuff.
What are you talking about?
Who'd lose most if Nikos and Maria started blabbing? Me. Only another business down the toilet. But all this, the cut glass wife. So, you shut their mouths for good, didn't you? Only they'll never believe you, did it? So, I've come for you myself.
Basilios?
It's a wonderfully paranoid plot, I'll give you that. The only flaw with it is that at the time of Maria's death, Mr. and Mrs. Vasilakis were at Glyndebourne seeing, what was it?
Rosengallery.
And there are over 800 people who can prove that he was sound asleep in the front row.
He didn't have to do it himself. He could have put out a contract.
This is not Las Vegas. I am not a Sicilian.
You're a Mediterranean. You all know how to make people disappear. That's how you hang on to all this loot.
Take him to the car.
Well, can't you see, Morse? You've been fooled by all his old money. He's not even his. He married it.
Come.
I'm coming, Wendy.
At least this means there won't be any question of the trireme coming to Britain. A happy ending for you.
It never really was. I'm afraid that chap was out of his class.
His wings came unstuck. I did warn him.
Morse. I'm glad I caught you. I just...
Where are you going with that?
Home, sir. Well, that's police property, Morse. I hope you've signed for it. Anyway, I just wanted to say good work at the Vasilakis base. Could have been a nasty incident. And Tuckerman?
He's been charged, sir.
Ah, good, good.
With forcible entry, with threatening behaviour and with assault. But I don't think he had anything to do with the killings or the baby. That's certainly what he claims, and I must say, I believe him.
What about the cars?
Sorry to keep you waiting. Forensic phoned just as I was leaving the office. They've been all over Tuckerman's car, and the wife's, and the mistress's. Nothing at all. Clean as a whistle.
What are you going to do with those things when you get them home? Catch up on your viewing?
Just an old tape I want to look at.
That's really what's made the whole thing worthwhile. The way the local people treated us. We've been made to feel as though Greece is our second home.
Believe that it actually happened, and it had.
What have I done now?
So you don't think you're going to be free of these nightmares for many years to come?
No. She get in there.
I'm going to try my best.
Lewis.
Thank you very much. Jack's account of her rape may have been harrowing, but it is not uncommon. There's no easy solution, which is why I'm always urging you to take a course in some kind of self-defense, if you possibly can. And now, on a personal note, I'd like to thank all of you who've written to congratulate me on my wedding anniversary. Now, I know compared to some of you, Randall and I are mere beginners, but well, 15 years seems quite a long time to us, doesn't it?
Oh, no, not at all. For me, it's gone in a flash.
Flattery will get you everywhere.
Thank you, darling.
Well, we were thinking, weren't we, over breakfast? What were the reasons?
It's Saturday, so it must be Friday.
And we decided that having different jobs had a lot to do with it. And also accepting the fact that our marriage was yet a third job. An ongoing labour of love.
Absolutely.
Which has to be worked at every day. And what we once thought of as the great sadness of our not having children, we realise has brought us even closer. Because, well, we've no one else to share our love. Only each other.
The lady doth protest too much, methinks.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you've enjoyed the show. So until the same time next week.
For us, the trireme scholars who've finally been proved right. And it's good to know that the first reconstruction will be staying here, where it belongs. Because this has been a collaboration between Brits and Greeks. That's really what's made the whole thing worthwhile. The way the local people treated us. We've been made to feel as though Greece is our second home.
You've been staring me in the face all this time, haven't you? My stupid fault for listening to bitchy gossip. Damn you, Jerome.
Hello. Oh, hello, sir. Reese, yeah, I've just been watching him on his wife's.
Well, if it's in an Oxford garage, we can soon locate it.
Yeah, fine.
Told the service manager there was no hurry for a week or two.
Makes sense.
You find anything?
Traces of Maria's body fluids, hair and clothing in the back of the car, and some threads on the exterior trim.
He's cool, Lewis. You must give him that.
And we thought he wasn't interested in women.
I did. Don't blame yourself. I put it into your head. And had it put into mine by malicious gossip. At my age, I should know better.
But they can't have kids. They said that on TV.
They can't, right. But who said he can't? He's been staring at me in the face from that screen right from the start.
So we're going for him?
No need to go in like the heavy brigade. I want a confession. You wait here till I call.
He's got no college duties today, so I take it he'll be home.
You know the address.
CID, Sergeant Lewis.
Oh, hello. How are you?
Did you expect?
I thought it might be Randall. Did he call you?
No. It's your husband I've come for.
I know.
So where is he?
You won't believe it. He's gone shopping. The baby wear, formula nappies. You've no idea how much a tiny creature like this can consume in a day. I couldn't go, of course. I'd be spotted. So he's taken the car and gone into town.
I take it that's Maria's child.
And his, yes. Pretty heavy irony, yes? The ideal married couple whose love was barren. The marriage made in paradise. The trouble is, it's true. I really do love him as much as that. Pathetic, really.
Even now? Now you know about the child?
terrible, babe. Poor innocent to be born into this. It all comes from a physiological flaw, you know. A technical hitch. We tried to put it right. Had all the treatments, hormones, in vitro fertilization. Nothing took. He wore loose pants and took cold baths, and I lay with my knees raised after sex. We had tried calendars and champagne and pornography, faith healing. God, the shame of it. They told us we should adopt. We didn't want to.
So you decided to do without.
After all, we had each other. An ideal relationship, a perfect sex life. Randall's a wonderful lover. He always was, in case you're in any doubt.
But he still hankered after a child of his own.
As I found out when a Greek chef turned up here with news of this poor babe. I wasn't here, he told me later. We always told each other everything.
Must have been a terrible shock to you.
You'd think so. Oddly enough, it was worse for him. I think he cared more about our public image than I did. Well, he cared enough to kill. I told Randall to give the girl's brother what he wanted, but only once. If he asked for more, then we should go to the police and take our chances. But Randall was terrified of blackmail. One night, I came back to find him in this hysterical state. He'd gone to the brother's digs to pay him, when all of a sudden he felt this sort of fit, an uncontrollable anger. And he struck him from behind. He swore he never meant to kill him. And I believe that. Don't you?
And Maria, are you saying that was an accident as well?
I don't know. Isn't it supposed to be easier the second time?
Why didn't you call me as soon as he left the house?
Don't you understand? I love him. Do you think I want him accused of murder? But it won't come to that, will it? We're the best lawyers.
Supposed to be there in case the inspector calls in.
I must do all I can to help. I feel so responsible for all that's happened.
We know who's responsible. I'm afraid whatever the old man's got to say, he's missed the boat.
What happened? Did you call him?
Stay where you are, I'm coming down.
I said no, Mr. Reese. It won't do any good.
What do you mean? Sooner or later, we'd have had to come. My fault it took so long.
And why have you left her up there with the baby?
It's perfectly safe. She's looking after it.
Not it, him. Alexander.
He and his wife were watching TV at the moment Nikos let in his caller.
His killer, you mean? The one they never saw?
He got bored, ran out of cigarettes, and went to the corner shop. On his way back, he saw someone. Someone in the street who couldn't possibly have been there.
How do you mean?
Because you can't be two places at one time. And he'd just seen the same face on television. He never mentioned it before as he was afraid of seeming a fool. But it wasn't a live show. It was a repeat of Saturday Night Show.
Friday Rees?
Yes, yes. He's here in the street. It's not me, it's Benicio Gusti.
He's apologizing.
Okay, let's hope you remembered in time. Trying to persuade her. This cannot go on. You're bound to find out sooner or later.
It could have gone on. We could have lived here together, a happy family. No one would have known.
Do you think you can hide a baby? Could I? No, not even in Greece. He found his way across a continent.
But I had strength for all three of us. I'd have done it somehow. I've always done what you thought was impossible.
Except to have a child. That you couldn't. Oh, yes, you've always been the strong one, but that you couldn't do.
Not another step.
She says. I've always done as she says, haven't I?
You were happy to let me manage your life.
Happy? I was half asleep. Even my one and only adultery with Maria didn't wake me up. But when her brother came here to show me the picture of my son, that was different.
Yes, after all our useless attempts, you had a one-night stand with a Greek scrubber! And bingo! My infertile husband!
No! With another woman, I could score first time!
Oh, why is it so important for men to prove themselves? You may be a wonderful lover, but all you want to do is to go out and procreate! Show what big macho men you are! And so it matters!
The woman in her was a public image. Perfect marriage, as seen on TV.
It is perfect now! We've got the baby!
He isn't yours! You killed his mother!
Friday, listen. Listen, we'll come up and we'll talk about this calmly.
I wanted to tell you that night at dinner. I've never been able to stand up to her.
You wait here.
When that girl followed, calling here and finding me alone, it all became suddenly clear to me. The baby really belonged to us. To him first, and now, because there was no mother, to me as well. If only you'd lean on me like you've always done.
No, that was over. He was someone weaker than myself who needed me to protect him.
Yes, but not for me. I'd be his mother.
You had killed his mother.
I did it for you. To protect you.
Thank you.
isn't yours.
Oh, they're so fragile. How do so many of them survive? I could drop him.
He isn't yours. Or ours. He's mine.
Is that what you really think?
Perhaps it could have been ours if Maria had agreed. But now...
Oh, my love. Try to understand what you've done.
Then if he isn't ours, if I can't share him...
Almost operatic. A Greek tragedy. You should try the myth sometime, Lewis. Sex is never simple, though. There's pleasure. Then there's payment. Retribution.
And my mother used to say, laughing always comes to crying.
Virgil said, I fear the Greeks, even when they come bearing gifts.